IPL is probably considered one of the most popular in-office dry eye treatments that you can get. So what is it? How does it work? What do you expect? We're going to go over all that in this video while I do IPL on myself. So this should be interesting to watch because this has quite the zap to it. So we'll see how this goes. Let's focus in. So IPL stands for intense pulsed light, and that's exactly what it does. It puts out short bursts of light energy to do the treatment. And this has been around for years. It's been in the dermatology world for years, where they actually use to treat rosacea, skin pigmentation or sunspots, helps with wrinkles and hair removal and overall skin rejuvenation. But what they found is when they were doing this on patients, they found a lot of patients were having improvement in their dry eye symptoms as well. And that's how you found it slowly evolve into being offered into eye care practices where they offered it to patients to help with their dry eyes. Now you might be asking yourself, okay, how does this actually help or treat dry eyes? The main way is through photocoagulation, where it actually takes the light and converts it into heat-inducing ablation of blood vessels. So what it does is it takes that light, heats up and coagulates, actually destroys these baby blood vessels. And we often call them telangiectasia, these little blood vessels that run along the eyelid or eyelid margin. And when you can actually get rid of those blood vessels, it eliminates the access of inflammatory cells that come from those blood vessels into the meibomian glands. So pretty much you're closing the door, you're stopping the access of inflammation. And that's what's really nice. That's probably the main way that IPL helps with dry eyes. Another way is, like I said, it actually provides heat to the oil glands. And what we're treating here is meibomian gland dysfunction, which is probably the majority of people that have dry eye symptoms have meibomian gland dysfunction or problems with their oil glands. If you don't have the right oil on your tears, then your tears will dry out faster. And so this will actually provide heat to the oil glands that can help liquefy the oil, that can actually help remove stagnant dried oil that are sitting in your oil glands. Now, I would say that this is more of a mild treatment, a mild heat to those oil glands. And so what you might find is you might find a lot of doctors that will do what's called meibomian gland expression right after you do the IPL procedure. This is where they go in there with usually Q-tips, maybe forceps, and actually squeeze those meibomian glands and squeeze out the oil. They kind of try and take advantage of some of the heat and liquefied oil by getting it out of the oil glands. And the other thing, the light energy can actually kill microorganisms that live on your eyelids. Specifically, we might be referring to something called Demodex or Demodex mites that live on your eyelids and hair follicles. And if they get out of control, they can cause something called Demodex blepharitis that can actually contribute to dry eyes. And so IPLs can actually work really well at eradicating Demodex from the eyelids and eyelashes. So it can actually be pretty nice in that aspect. Okay, now getting into the actual procedure. Now that your face is numb, you've washed your face, washed all the makeup off, everything, then the doctor will probably apply an eye shield. And there are a few ways that they might do this. They can either do an on the eyeball eye shield. This will be a corneal shield to protect the cornea. So they'll insert that in there. Kind of looks like this. Or they might have an over the eyelid shield that they kind of stick right on there. Or they might have these type of goggles that actually protect the eye. Now, it depends on the doctor and the patient. A lot of times when they're going to use the on-the-eye shield, they're probably wanting to get closer up into the eyelid, maybe the eyelid margins, maybe that patient has a lot of baby blood vessels, the telangiectasia that they want to try and get rid of. Most of the time, I'd probably say most doctors are going to use the on-the-eye shield or the goggles. When you kind of get close to the eyelid, you can still get a really effective treatment. And so you might find your doctor using that a lot, but it really depends on the doctor and the patient. For today and the purpose of this video, I'm just gonna wear the eye filter sunglasses, the glasses that the doctor usually wears when they're doing IPL, just so I can actually see what I'm doing. And this is just gonna be an example of IPL. I'm gonna try not to get close to my eye or eyelids or anything, but I'll kind of go forehead and cheek so you can kind of see what it's like. But yeah, this is what I'll be wearing, and this is usually what your doctor's going to wear as well. So I'm gonna turn the machine on, and it is kind of loud, but I wanna get the correct settings in there. And what I mean by the correct settings is there are certain energy level settings that you set depending on the patient's skin type or skin complexion. And this is one downside to IPL. People with darker complexions shouldn't be doing IPL because it can actually cause hypopigmentation, unwanted results. And so I'm gonna set my settings in there and then we'll get started. As it gets going, I wanted to mention this applicator, this probe right here, actually has a cooling effect. And so when you're actually doing the treatment, it does create a lot of heat. And so this gets really cold, so it tries to counteract that heat so it's not too hot on the skin. To do the procedure, your doctor is likely gonna use a lot of this gel, this ultrasonic gel, all over the face. It helps create a good seal and application to the skin. And I have found with the patients that we do it on, the more the better, it seems like. If there's a little bit of gel, it tends to zap a little bit more. So I'm gonna start applying that. Now, IPL does have different filters that you can put in there depending on where you wanna target the energy. There's certain filters that work the best for skin rejuvenation and dry eyes. Some filters work better for dark sunspots or wrinkle remover or hair removal. So it depends on what you're doing and you can actually change those filters out. Okay, I'm gonna get started here. Like I said, there's a good zap to it. Definitely does not feel good. It's like someone flicking your face. So we'll see how I do here. But one thing, it does do a flash of light. So if you're sensitive to flashes of light, you can fast forward this part. But I'm gonna go over to treatments and timing and everything like that. So here we go. This is what I usually do on patients. I actually do a test spot to see how the patient feels. If it's hurting way too much, then I back it down. If the patient doesn't feel it at all, then I'm definitely gonna bump it up. So here we go, this is my test spot. And we're gonna do it right on the forehead. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. That's not bad at all. I'm gonna actually bump it up. Now I'm gonna continue around the forehead and then we'll work down the cheeks and I'll show you the dry eye pass here. Here we go. So, treatment of IPL, you can actually get them in single application. So usually you can buy kind of one treatment. Or what's more common is you can buy them in a package or a bundle deal. And this usually involves 4 sessions. 4 sessions, most people have found, actually does the best, where you actually see the best results. You can see results after the first session, but really after the second, third session, it really does start helping, because usually the second and third session, you can start bumping up the energy because the patient can tolerate a little bit more. Now, pricing-wise, definitely depends on the office. You can get single packages. They can range from $250 to $600, and then bundle packages ranging from $1,000 to $3,000, depending on what they're doing. Now, I'm gonna do what's called the dry eye pass. You go from ear to ear, go close to the eyelids. Now, I'm gonna go hang down a little bit near my cheeks, just because, you know, I'm wearing these glasses, just to kind of show you what it does. But yeah, this is usually a common treatment that you'll see is right along there. So here we go, kind of stay right out here. 3, 2, 1. Hiya. 3, 2, 1. Yellow. 3, 2, 1. Yep, okay. I gotta try and avoid the glasses here. 3, 2, 1. Yep, mama. 3, 2, 1. Yeah, you just feel a little bit more. Now, usually a sensitive part for patients is right around the nose, those crevices. 3, 2, 1. Golly. 3, 2, 1. Yep. 1, 1. And 1. I got. Okay, yeah. Woo! Okay, we're gonna keep going here before I fast forward this part. Now, the one thing I will say is there's enough energy here to actually singe hair. So if I went down to my beard area, it would singe those smoke. You'd actually kind of smell the singed hair smell. So I'm gonna stay away from that. But I'm gonna go a little bit lower on my cheek here. Now, usually with the dry eye pass, they'll probably do 2 passes. But again, depends on the person, but you might expect them to go over that area twice. Now, for this video here, I did a mild application here. It's tricky looking at myself in the video here, but I just wanted to show you what it would be like. But they might, after that, go over different areas, depending on if they want to treat rosacea, other blood vessels, dark spots, wrinkles, anything like that, where they'll change the filter and energy settings to target those areas again. Now, afterwards, the thing to expect is your skin might look a little red where they did the treatment, or you might see your blood vessels are have like a dark purple color, or maybe like a bruised color, and that is normal. That means it actually did target the skin, and you might have this the rest of the day, or maybe even up to a few days. And then once it gets resolved, that's when your skin can actually feel great. Your skin does really feel rejuvenated. That's one of the best parts about IPL, is that it really does help collagen production, helps rejuvenate your skin, and your skin does really feel and look great after IPL. Now, after the one session, they'll give you the instructions to leave, try and use sunscreen, trying to stay out of the sun for the day, but they'll probably schedule you to come back for your second, third, fourth session, depending on if you got the bundle. And usually they're spaced about 2 to 4 weeks, depending on the patient. And so that's one thing to expect, is you'll probably do this every 2 to 4 weeks. And then after that, if the results came out great, sometimes people just do maintenance treatments, maybe every 6 months or at the year mark, or it just depends on the patient. And one thing I forgot to mention is that this is usually cash pay. There hasn't really been any insurances that can cover IPL. And so, yeah, you are expecting to pay cash for this procedure. Okay, I'm gonna go clean the rest of my face off. Now, if you are at a doctor where they're gonna do meibomian gland expression, they'll probably do that right after they do the procedure, where you get behind the microscope, the slit lamp, and they actually kind of squeeze the oil glands to kind of clean out those oil glands. And so that would probably be next before they send you home and schedule you for the next session. But yeah, hopefully that helped kind of just give an overview of what IPL is and what it does and how it can help. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments, or you can check out my other dry eye videos right here. Stay focused.